Hello, my name is Tony Dean. I'm the technical manager for Phoenix Contact UK. In recent years, digitalization has been used to find a solution to many of today's problems. In this particular application, the issue to be solved is how to clear weeds from a railway company's infrastructure without using chemicals. Our partner in this is Schweizer Bundesbahnen, the Swiss Federal Railway. Ordinarily, weeds around the infrastructure of a track are cleared by using a powerful weed killer called glyphosate. This is administered by hand, on foot by operatives, and we are also putting tons of glyphosate into the local environment. So, together with a team from Schweizer Bundesbahnen and Phoenix Contact, we devised a plan whereby we would eradicate the weeds from the infrastructure without using this powerful weed killer, glyphosate. And it looks like this.
We're in a train that sprays hot water on the tracks. Our goal is to remove the vegetation in the track area with hot water. Our ultimate aim is to end the practice of using a chemical solution, therefore making the process both eco-friendly and sustainable.
A hot water train is exactly what it says it is. It's a train with lots of hot water on it that runs across the tracks, and it dispenses the hot water across the tracks and across the weeds. But these weeds have to be targeted. When the hot water hits the plants, it explodes the plant cells, and the plant's DNA disintegrates, and the plant eventually dies. And we have our solution. We have eradicated the weeds without using chemicals. I'll now show you how this works. We have the PLC control in the train, and on the underside of a train, we have these weed seekers, we call them, special sensors. The weed passes under the detector, and hot water is released onto the plant, bursting its cells. As you can see, the information from the weed seeker goes into the controller. The position of the weed, the size of the weed, also taken into account is the speed or velocity of the train. A calculation is made in the PLCnext control, and then a decision is made by the PLCnext control when and where to open the valves to target the plants that have been detected.
The big challenge is the speed. We're traveling at 40 kilometers per hour. That means we have about 10 meters per second. The plant must be identified in milliseconds. The signals must also be calculated, and the valves have to be controlled within this time period. The reaction time is critical. This must be accurate down to the millisecond. If we open the valve 1 to 10 milliseconds too late, then we will miss the plant.
So, as Herr Lucas Tanner explains, this is not just a simple application, because this has to happen in real time. The train is moving at 40 kilometers per hour. Therefore, from detection, this must happen in milliseconds. Due to the dual core architecture of the PLCnext control, tasks which are not time critical can be performed on core 1, and all real-time tasks are controlled in core 2. Therefore, anything that needs to be processed in real time is actually processed in real time. Eventually, the solution will become far more efficient as the controllers will be connected directly to the profit cloud. It is then intended to separate the detection from the actual treatment of the plants. Detection will be done by regional trains going about their normal business. This information will be sent directly to the profit cloud. There will also be collection of data via drones and other methods. These will be sent to a separate IT infrastructure at Schweizer Bundesbahnen. Because of the open architecture of the PLCnext ecosystem, interconnectivity between different IT infrastructures, including the profit cloud, is an easy task.
At the moment, this is still an autonomous system. However, the idea is that if in the future you attach other systems, you can couple this new data with existing data. This would be relatively easy, either through the databases or via high-level languages. One idea is that the whole thing is linked to the GIS system, i.e. the geographic information system. With the systems combined, this will give us position detection. And of course, it is important that an automatic data exchange can then take place between all of these systems. Because of the openness of the PLCnext technology ecosystem, the exchange of information between a wide array of systems is easy.
So, we look at what results we have. Normally, under normal circumstances, 2.5 tons of glyphosate was being put into the local environment. We have now got 0 because we are using hot water to eradicate the weeds. Also, because we are now using data, we can now do targeted eradication of the weeds. Also, the infrastructure of Schweizer Bundesbahnen covers 7,600 miles. That's as far from Nuremberg to Beijing. Can you imagine how many man hours it would take to treat this area? So because of PLCnext technology, we now have safe travel because we are eradicating the weeds. We now have sustainable travel because the weeds are being eradicated without the use of chemicals. And we have efficiency, we have efficient travel, because we are now targeting the coverage and only areas that need treatment are being treated. So, to summarize, real-time performance, the dual-core architecture of PLCnext technology allows us to get real-time performance. Because of cloud connectivity, the data is captured and sent up into the profit cloud. And because of the openness of the PLCnext technology ecosystem, it is very easy to connect with other IT infrastructures. Therefore, information can be shared. And hence, we now have an efficient, safe, green application. So, whether in transport, general infrastructure, or any application, the scalability of PLCnext technology makes it the obvious choice for any automation application. Let us rethink automation together with PLCnext technology. Now please, visit our workshop. Anything I have spoken about today, my colleagues will be more than happy to discuss it with you. And also, including your own projects that may be pending or you may be in the planning stage. My colleagues, as I said, are more than happy to help you. Thank you very much. Let's rethink automation with PLCnext technology.